Hi, welcome back to my series on musical set theory. Before we start, I want to apologize for the mistake in my first video. Obviously, four semitones is not a minor third, but a major third. Making these videos is more complicated than you think. You start with a script, but then when creating the examples, you make some adjustments, and sometimes you forget to correct the script. Then, while recording, you are so focused on things like pronunciation and background noise that you miss what otherwise would be an easy-to-spot mistake. Then you need to create the images, thumbnail, timestamps, write down the description, etc. When you finish and upload the result, it turns out that you've missed some error, and by the time you notice it, or someone else tells you, you can no longer do anything, because YouTube does not give you the option to re-upload a video without losing ratings and comments. Anyway, lesson learned. I'll pay more attention this time, and hope no more mistakes like that happen. But if they do, let me know in a comment, and I'll put an errata in the description like I did last time. In my previous video, I explained some basic concepts about this theory, but there are others that I still need to explain, so that's what I plan to do in this video. I hope you don't find all this theory too boring. You don't really have to use all of these concepts when applying set theory to composition, but you do need them to understand the theory itself and what can be achieved with it. I have already explained what pitch class sets are. It turns out that there is another kind of class in set theory, the interval class. As you can imagine, it refers to the interval formed by two elements of a PC set. In set theory, we don't talk about intervals like major, minor, diminished, etc. Intervals are expressed simply as plain numbers. They are the arithmetic difference between two PCs, and only positive values are used. There are 12 intervals, of course, and they are reduced to 6 classes using the same logic as PC sets, that is, considering an interval and its inversion as belonging to the same class. For practical reasons, class 0, the unison, is omitted. Interval classes are denoted using the prefix I, followed by a number. Therefore, the interval class between PCs 0 and 1, C and C sharp, is I1, because both notes form either a minor second or a major seventh. The one between PCs 4 and 7, E and G, is I3, because they define a minor third or a major sixth. And the one between PCs 8 and 3, A flat and E flat, is I5, because we can say they define either a perfect fourth or a perfect fifth. So, as you see, in set theory, the direction of the interval, up or down, is meaningless. The next concept is called interval vector. It is a way of describing the total interval content of a PC set, and is constructed by counting the number of occurrences of each interval class between the elements of a set, and writing the results in an ordered sequence of integers without spaces or commas. The interval vector is related to the cardinal number of a set, which must be at least 4 so that all interval classes are present. For example, let's take set 4-1, 0, 1, 2, 3. This set contains 3 occurrences of I1, 2 of I2, and 1 of I3. Therefore, its interval vector is 3, 2, 1, followed by 3 zeros. Interestingly, there are only 2 PC sets with cardinal 4 in which the vector doesn't have any input equivalent to 0, 4Z15 and 4Z29, which are commonly known as the all-interval tetrachords. These 2 PC sets are a Z-related pair, a concept which I'll explain in a moment, and they were used extensively by Elliot Carter in the composition of many of his works. 2 sets are said to be equivalent if they can both be reduced to the same prime form, either by transposition and or inversion. On the other hand, we have seen that the interval content of a PC set can be represented as a sequence of numbers. As a result of this, one could conclude that each prime form has a different interval vector, but this is not the case. For example, the 2 all-interval tetrachords are constructed in such a way that they are not equivalent by either transposition and or inversion, and yet both have identical vectors, a sequence of ones. This may seem counterintuitive, because we are accustomed to using groups of notes that are unique in terms of their interval content. There is no other way to combine a major third and a perfect fifth and produce something that is different from a major or a minor chord. Remember that both the major and the minor chords are listed as a single set. This is true for all three note sets, but not for sets of higher cardinal. A pair of PC sets like the ones I mentioned before, that have identical vectors but are not equivalent by transposition or inversion, such as 4Z15 and 4Z29, are said to be in a Z relation. They are a Z-related pair. The letter Z has no special meaning. It's only used to identify this special type of relationship, an invention of Forte himself. There are 19 Z-related pairs in the total universe of PC sets. In addition to the pair of cardinal 4, there are 3 pairs of cardinal 5 and 15 pairs of cardinal 6. A Z-related pair provides a way to switch from a set to another without changing the interval content of the music. It would be like having another set of pitches that produce the same intervals of a major chord but don't form a major chord, which we all know is not possible. The next concept is inclusion. You may remember this one from your math classes at school. A set may be included within another set of a higher cardinal, or it may include other sets of lower cardinal. In the first case, we say that the set is a subset. In the second case, it is a superset. For example, 419 is a subset of 530, which is, of course, a superset of 419. In mathematical set theory, this type of relationship is represented by these symbols. The first means is included, and the second means includes. Then, the relationship I described before can be expressed as follows. That is, 419 is included in 530. Or it could be described like this, which reads, 530 includes 419. From a musical point of view, these relationships are equivalent to those that occur in tonal music, when one chord is contained within another. For example, B-flat major is contained within G minor 7. Another important concept is called invariance. Given two PC sets A and B, a third PC set C can be constructed with those elements that are present in both A and B. In mathematical set theory, this is known as the intersection of A and B, and is represented thus. The elements of this set are then known as invariants, and are of special importance in music, their main function being to provide harmonic continuity. Invariance occurs when a set is subjected to a transposition, or inversion, or both, and makes reference to the elements of the initial state of the set that remain constant after those operations. For example, if set 047 is transposed by a value of 4, major third, we obtain 4811. The invariant in this example is PC4, E. This time I got it right, huh? Finally, I need to explain what the term complement means. The complement of a PC set A is another PC set B that contains all the elements of the universe not present in A. Remember, our universe in musical set theory has only 12 elements, the 12 pitch classes. In Forte's list, the PC sets have been ordered in such a way that the complement of any set can be found easily changing the cardinal number for its inversion. For example, if we have PC set 3-8, its complement is 9-8, because 9 plus 3 equals 12. One of the first properties of complements is that they have inclusion relationships between them. Thus, PC set 4-5 is included in 8-5. In other words, it is possible to group at least 4 elements of 8-5 in such a way that reducing the set to its prime form produces PC set 4-5. Another important characteristic is the property that some PC sets have of keeping their complement invariant by means of transposition or inversion, or both. On the other hand, some sets of cardinal 6, typically known as hexachords, can produce their complement by these operations. For example, the complement of set 635 is set 635. Obviously, if you transpose the set, it remains the same, but that is also true for its inversion. In other words, the inversion of set 635 is identical to its complement, and turns out to be none other than set 635 itself. That's all for now. We have covered all the important concepts of musical set theory. In my next video, I'll show you some examples of its application in musical analysis. Until then, take care. Ciao.